Hello, Covai Post viewers. Today we have with us Dr. Krishna Kishor, the cardiothoracic surgeon of Royal Care Hospital, and we will be speaking about cardiac issues. Now, something that he says he is seeing very often is the leak in the valves, heart valves. So how does this happen? Following an attack, a heart attack, a patient suffers a leak in the valve, and this, he says, is mostly because there is insufficient blood supply to the valve. Let us hear from him more about it. Doctor, thank you so much for talking to us.
Pleasure is mine.
So tell us about this heart leak which you are seeing very often now. So what is the incidence, doctor, to start with?
It's about 12 to 13% of patients who have heart attack develop a leak in the valve.
Okay.
It's predominantly the mitral valve that starts leaking. If you look at the human coronary circulation, there are two systems, the left system and the right system.
Okay.
The mitral valve is held by papillary muscles and cauda. They are finer structures which are inside the ventricle and which need blood supply. So the left system supplies the papillary muscles and the right system also supplies the papillary muscles. We do see a big number of patients who have combined heart attack, all the vessels being involved.
Okay.
So the total blood supply to the myocardium and to the papillary muscles are at geopathy.
Almost. Okay.
So this leads to acute rupture of the papillary muscles, and then there is a florid mitral regurgitation.
Doc, you have to be, you know, use as less jargons as possible. Make it very, so that the viewer understands. Yeah.
So there is a florid leak in the valve,
okay,
causing heart failure.
Okay.
How does it present? If you ask me the next question, they present with breathlessness. They are not able to lie down.
Breathe.
They are not able to sit properly. They are short of breath, and they are air hunger.
Okay.
Air hunger starts. And then there is...
That's frothing. Because the lungs are not able to function?
Yes.
There's
too much of blood that's being pumped into the lungs.
The blood is flooded in the lungs.
And then the blood saturation drops, patient becomes comatose, and lands up in acute heart failure.
Okay. So, Doc, you are... the treatment for this would be valve replacement.
Yes.
Right. So there are two options. One is repair and one is replacement. Why do you think replacement is better?
See, I take two points into consideration. One is our Indian economic strata.
Okay.
What we tend to see is middle class and upper middle class patients. Be it even the higher class, how many of them can afford a second surgery is one question.
So for repair, when it comes to repair, two surgeries are mandatory.
It might be. All repairs are successful.
Okay.
They develop secondary leaks because of heart remodeling. Remodeling means the heart shape changes in due course.
Okay. So what do you do when it comes to repair, Doc?
In repair, what we do is we fix the ruptured tissue, and then we put a ring around the valve. So the valve diameter is reduced and the leak is reduced.
Okay.
But here in replacement, why I prefer is second surgery is avoided. Second thing is the morbidity is elevated. When a patient goes for a second surgery, the re-entry into the chest is a difficult task.
Yes, it's dangerous.
There's quite a bit of bleeding and morbidity is pretty high. So, in order to alleviate all these issues, I have chosen
replacement
as an option.
Okay.
In that also, what I do, I don't replace, I don't excise the entire tissue. I preserve them and then put a valve.
Okay. Now, you use prosthetic valves, right?
Yes, for
the replacement. So, how affordable it is and what is the success rate? How long can it keep going?
Prosthetic valves can function lifelong provided the anticoagulation, meaning the blood thinners, are being used properly.
Yeah, without a break. Okay.
The only side effect of using a blood thinner, an anticoagulant, what I mean is cerebral hemorrhage. in elderly age group.
Okay.
Patients who are hypertensive, they can have aneurysms and minor break in the cerebral circulation.
Okay.
So they may
that is when the blood rushes to your brain.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay.
When the pressure rises, the aneurysm can rupture and then cause a stroke.
Hmm.
So that's the only side effect of a anticoagulation. But weighing the pros and cons, I still feel prosthetic valve is a better option than going in for a repair.
Okay.
Because I am totally free of second surgery and the valve is going to function lifelong.
Okay. So doc, this ischemic heart diseases, is it on the rise? What is it and why is it on the rise?
There are a subset of patients who don't have any substance abuse nor sedentary lifestyle, who are very active at a younger age group. They present with coronary artery disease. If you ask me why, that is because of familial hypercholesterolemia. It's a genetic disorder wherein the synthesis of fat, that is cholesterol, is at a higher level than the normal individual.
Yeah. So, doc, the deposition of the cholesterol starts from an early age is what
yes.
you say. So,
yes.
are they mostly asymptomatic? Why are you not able to catch them early?
No, we do catch them early.
Okay.
Predominantly, they escape medical examinations, meaning they don't subject themselves for a master health checkup or a periodic health checkup at an early stage, unless there is a conception that until you, a patient is about 40 years of age, you do, or an individual who is about 40 years of age, you don't need a blood checkup or anything. But it's a misconception.
Right.
So anybody can have a disease which may be indolent, which may not be evident to the normal scenario, but eventually once they become subjective to medical tests, they being picked up.
Okay. Okay. And doc, are you, why are we seeing cardiac issues less among women as compared to men?
Yeah. Estrogen, the female hormone, happens to be a savior. It prevents heart attack by protecting the heart from cholesterol and other agents. So it's a protective hormone. So predominantly you don't see it in the premenopausal women. Postmenopausal women who don't take hormone replacement therapy, they are prone for
okay. heart attack. Okay. So doctor, what are the different types of valves that you use when it comes to valve replacement? I mean, is it Indian? Is it, you know, those that are imported from abroad? And what is the affordability factor?
Yeah. This is a bigger question to be answered. We have two different kinds of valves. One is a metallic valve and second one is a biological valve. Biological valve is made from porcine and bovine tissue. Whereas metallic valves are made out of carbon. Pyrolytic carbon is the material that's being used. So if you look at both the valves, both are being manufactured in India. But if research papers which support the long-term outcome is predominantly on the Western valves. So Indian valves, we do have the metallic valves alone with a bigger database. So I prefer the Indian valve, which is TTK Chitra, which was developed indigenously, and it has a very good result in our patients.
Okay, and the cost factor, doctor?
Yeah, Indian valves are half the cost of valves that are being imported from abroad. But if you look at the complications, there aren't any complications whatsoever because of the valve structure by and large.
Okay, okay. So thank you so much for talking to Coimbatore. Thank
you. Pleasure is mine.